Lucius, girls, thought I told you to wait inside.
I'm not scared when there's blood to be spilled. Where's the other one that's?
When you've got hair on your chin, you can talk of blood. Breen, I expected better. Next time, do as you're told.
They're just hungry people. They've not hurt us.
Hungry people do strange things.
Then Blessed Orbona will protect us.
Well, run along and ask her to send a grain ship. Me and Mascus have to talk. You too, Lucius. Go learn to read or something. What's the tally?
10 days left, a quarter ration, give or take.
Gods below.
It's hardly worth giving out, just prolonging the misery.
Morning.
Baker's Guild man was round earlier.
I told you not to speak to them.
Nor did I. He spoke. I said nothing. They're offering 600 a sack.
600?
600 and a few dead children for every sack that doesn't get to the people that need them. We're not in this for profit.
Ah, still at 600.
I'd piss on the Baker's Guild.
Your call?
Yes, it is.
Why are you wasting valuable food on him still? Let the poor bastard die.
Memio? No. He reminds the other men to stay honest.
What's to be done then?
Fetch my best clothes. I'll see if his honor has any ideas.
Hey! Quiet, you. You fucking hairy bastard.
So far, it's just the old and the sick that are dying. But by next moon, our granaries will be empty.
I understand that that dogs make good eating.
They do. Tastes like pork if you cook them right. All gone.
Ah. I wondered why the nights were so peaceful. No barking.
This is no moment for wit.
I wish there was something I could do, but the state granaries are near as empty as yours. I can only give to you by taking from someone else.
The military silos are untapped.
And the army needs to eat.
Well, then send 3 legions to Africa. Let Lepidus feed them. That would supply the city with enough grain for a month.
Have it done. It's only a temporary solution, but it's the best we can offer. I'll send you what we can spare.
Thank you.
Pullo. Tell me what the people are saying. Tell me who they blame for this famine.
You, they say. You're the man in charge.
Not Antony.
They hear the newsreader saying that he's holding back the shipments and all that, but... well, it's Antony, isn't it? Why would he starve them? They've always loved him. And he's always loved to be loved. Whereas you... well, you're you, aren't you?
Cold and heartless.
I'll not say that. But you've never been the affectionate type now, have you?
Thank you, Pullo.
I'll be hearing about the grain then, will I?
Agrippa will see to it.